at least with the hematopoietic stem cells, like I'm not sure about with you know other stem cells in other tissues, but I know that they, when they're quiescent, when they're not dividing, they are glycolytic, meaning they use glucose for energy because they don't want to damage themselves with reactive oxygen species being generated from, you know, as a byproduct of mitochondrial function, right? But I do know that when they come out of quiescence and they come out to either self-renew or differentiate into progenitor cells, they become oxidative phosphorylation becomes their source of making energy. And so I'm wondering if there's, what the signal, I know you've published some studies on looking at different signaling pathways that are required to cause this hematopoietic stem cell self-renewal mechanism, but I'm wondering if possibly just not having the glucose available and having just the, you know, fatty acids, the source of energy that can only be used by mitochondria, if that somehow also is playing a role in making them self-renew more or differentiate more.
I think so, and this is the work by David Sabatini and others at MIT, and they're doing work on the fat and the role of fat and fatty acids, et cetera, on self-renewal and on the activation of stem cells, particularly in the gut. So, there seems to be a role for fat in that, and I think it's still... we're still beginning to understand it. I think obviously with fasting, you produce fat and you produce fatty acids and glycerol and ketone bodies. So the environment is there and we need to maybe understand more how each component that is changing is affecting the program. So we made the decision to try to, I think things are going very slow and we've always been very interested in people that have a problem now, right? Instead of,
right.
You know, a lot of people are like, well, you know, in 20 years we'll have this. And we always said, you know, there's people that have cancer now, they have multiple sclerosis now. So what do you do for them, right? And so our decision has been always understand enough the mechanisms to be able to not or minimize the chance of making mistakes. Get to the disease, get to the clinical trial, and then go back and fill it in, right? Rather than step by step by step by step, you know, and then it'll take you 15 years to get to the clinical trial. So, yep. I mean, I'm not criticizing the other method, but I'm just saying that for us has been get the mechanism, get enough mechanism, move to the clinical trial, and then make sure it's safe.
It's been fantastic. I mean, you've been able to translate so many different studies. I mean, it's really quite phenomenal. I'm just sort of thinking, in fact, I just thought about it when you were mentioning the ketone bodies too. Well, ketone bodies are a more, if you think about the stem cells and if they need energy to differentiate or self-renew, ketone bodies would actually provide a very energetically favorable source because it takes less oxygen actually to convert beta-hydroxybutyrate into acetyl-CoA as opposed to glucose into pyruvate. So if you think about it, it's more energetically favorable to have ketone bodies. And so maybe it also helps just because it takes less energy to do this process. I mean, you know, it's possible, but...
Yeah, you know. I think it's also, there's also mechanisms, again, the fasting imposes this new metabolic profile, and the new metabolic profile requires the stem cells for this regeneration that I mentioned. So if you got to get rid of half of your liver, let's say that you fast for a month and a half, right? Then you must, you will produce tons of fatty acids and tons of ketone bodies. And that environment is going to require the stem cells to be renewing and being standing by for the day where you need to make a new liver, essentially, or health of the liver, right? So this is why I think it's all a part of a coordinated response where, you know, you have the fat. And by then, the fat is one of the few sources, abundant sources of energy also for the stem cells. So they really have no choice but to be ready to respond to fat metabolites so that they can self-renew, because there's not much sugar around, and the brain needs the sugar, by the way, right? So the brain needs a lot of the sugar that is available. A lot of it is made by gluconeogenesis, so it makes sense.
Red blood cells need it, since they have no mitochondria.
Right, and so it makes sense that you will have a system like that, that is fat and fatty acid and ketone bodybuilding.
Yeah, absolutely.